got their nerve running that snail in the third race. Lost me a 10 spot last week.
Tilly, I want to turn to page 5.
Why can't you do as I do? Read all the starts of the stories first and the continues after.
I've done it. It's wonderful. It's revolutionary.
What is it today, Simon?
Look, one cereal box full of cereal, one toy in the bottom of the box. The problem is, how do we remove the toy without spilling the contents or eating all the cereal, getting a bellyache? Solution?
Looks like a sea crab has lost his shell.
Now, we put it in here like this. And it's working its way down to the bottom. Now it's searching for the toy.
On the edge of my seat. I've heard of high fiber, but this is ridiculous.
Back to the drawing board, I suppose. What is it, Tilly?
I don't believe it.
The horse you won on?
No, no. Jimmy Woodvale's riding in the 9th race.
Jimmy, here?
Yeah, on Marigold. Ooh, what a dog. Ooh, 45-1 shot.
He always did like the underdog. He was my first friend in the States. We shared a lot of interests.
Oh, yeah, jelly donuts, chocolate eclairs, strawberry shortcake.
We were on first-name terms with every baker from Flatbush to Brighton Beach.
Whatever I used to put into port, there would be Simon and Jimmy waiting at the Fulton Street docks, yapping like two sea dogs. Then we'd hightail it over at the track and watch Jimmy ride.
What did you say the name of that horse was?
Marigold.
Let's go.
Down the back stretch, Dark Sable on the lead, Marigold second, Bismarck in third, a gap of 2 lengths to Scott's Folly, then comes Burial's Dream and Fairy Time Trails. Here on the far third, Dark Sable in the lead by a half, Marigold second by a length, Bismarck running easily in third.
You got him.
And here comes Bismarck gaining ground fast on the rail, Dark Sable still in front by a length, Bismarck now second, Marigold dropping back. As they round the grandstand turn for home, it's Bismarck now on the lead. Down the home stretch they come, it's Bismarck drawing away. Dark Sable hanging on in second, always pretty challenging on the outside. And at the wire, it's Bismarck by 5 lengths, always pretty getting up to second. Dark Sable fading to third.
The results of the 9th and last race are official. Bismarck, the winner.
Come on, let's go and see what Jimmy's doing.
Dark Sable was...
Yeah, you guys go ahead. I'll catch up with you in a minute.
You know, the last time I saw Jimmy was...
There he blows! Of bone and flesh, Jimmy Woodvale!
I know that voice anywhere. It's Simon.
Hey, you remind me of a man.
What man?
Man power.
What power?
Power of voodoo.
Voodoo?
You do.
Do what?
Remind me of a man.
What man?
You do remind me of the old days.
No, in the old days, I used to win.
Now you stop that.
Hope you guys didn't bet on me.
Well, of course we did.
I wouldn't bet on anyone else.
Simon, I wish your optimism was contagious.
Well, don't stand too close to me. You might start smiling.
There he is. Uncle Jimmy!
Uncle Jimmy!
You rated him right,
but the two horses squeezed you turning for home.
The Marigold isn't enough horse to close ground.
That's right.
How's this for a fan club?
Simon and Tilly, this is Katie, my associate trainer, and her brother, Tim.
Pleased to meet you.
Are you a man or a boy?
Well, tell you the truth, I'm a little bit of both.
Don't let him fool you, he's mostly boy.
With a heart of 10 men.
Are you a jockey, too? I'm gonna be one.
Well, I like riding horses, but I make toys for a living.
Haven't you heard of the wizard?
You're the wizard? We have a lot of your toys.
I mean, we used to.
The topsy-turvy was the best. Made people crazy.
Should have seen what it did to me trying to make it.
All right, you two. Why don't you go find Ben and tell him to saddle Kubla for a workout?
Raisha, let's win their queen!
They're great. Are they visiting you?
No. My sister and her husband were killed in a boating accident 4 months ago.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jimmy.
I've got temporary custody of him.
I'm trying to make it permanent, but the court's giving me trouble. Say the track's no place to bring up kids.
Well, being with someone who loves them is more important than where they are.
Tell that to the adoption people. They say kids need a permanent dwelling. I'm afraid if they take Katie and Tim away from me, they'll put them in separate homes.
Those two need each other and they need you. Anyone can see that.
Well, I've got an angle on it. It's a long shot, but... Simon.
No matter how many times I do this, I love this part the best. Oh, thank you. Good job.
Smiles. Mm. Hold it, please. Let me get a photograph. All of my money goes.
Ignore him. Maybe he'll go away.
Cheese, everyone.
Maybe I don't want him to go away.
I won this race for you.
Please hold it right there.
Look. What happened between us never should have happened. It's over. You're my trainer, and that's the extent of our relationship.
You enjoy the winner's circle, don't you?
I don't like losing. I'm Whitney Ross.
Alex Jagger.
Good job.
Whoa. Bridling yourself. That horse is local.
Bit of the devil in him, huh?
So I could afford to buy him. Still had to hawk everything I own. It's all about breaking a horse without breaking his spirit. His first trainer didn't know the difference.
Oh, he doesn't trust people, eh?
What's his name? Kubla's Fire. Is he ready to race?
You better be. It's my only shot.
The review board meets on Monday to decide about the kids. If we can just win the Pacific Futurity on Saturday...
We're gonna buy a house for us all.
Let me see if I can get this bridle on him. I'll show you what he's made of.
Do you mind if I try?
He's got a temper.
It's a good thing Alex isn't here.
Careful.
Are you an owner, Alex?
Businessman with an interest in horses.
Horses aren't an interest, they're a passion. Sometimes even an obsession. There's nothing in the world more beautiful than a thoroughbred surging out of the gate.
I might have to disagree with you on that. Tell me, Whitney, what is it about some women and horses?
Oh, horses are strong, powerful, and with the proper handling, they'll do anything you want them to do.
If a man did that, I'll bet you'd be bored in a minute.
That's why I prefer horses.
Easy, boy. Kubla. Kubla, easy, boy. Good boy. Kubla. For a run, isn't it?
To the future.
To the futurity. That's the race I want to win.
And you usually get what you want, don't you?
When I want it badly enough. To winners.
We're toasting today's victory. I should join in, don't you think?
Alex Jagger, this is my trainer, Randy Covington.
Congratulations on Bismarck's run.
Just a workout for Saturday. Bismarck's quarter mile was 23 flat.
And to the thrill of victory.
And the agony of defeat.
Oh, you did.
a magnificent horse. Look.
It's Kubla's Fire.
Why haven't I seen him before?
He's a renegade. J&H Stables had him. He's a bust. Some washed-up jock, Woodvale, Jimmy Woodvale, bought him.
Jimmy's a friend of a friend of mine.
Yeah?
Randy, clock that horse for a quarter mile. Fits faster than Bismarck's.
Yeah, well, don't worry. He'll win the futurity. You can bank on it.
Ambulance.
Oh, my God.
Oh. Oh. Uncle Jimmy!
Dr. Schreffler, call 5942. Dr. Schreffler, please call 5942. Ugh.
Simon?
Jimmy, this room is gonna take an awful lot of doing. There's no color, no pizzazz. Hospitals are an awful place to get well in. Oh, oh, nurse!
Nurse Shore, report to ICU. Report to ICU.
Drink up your soup, Jimmy, or you won't get better.
You always did this to me, Simon. Cheered me up through all the bad spills, the broken bones, the worst of fix I was in, the harder you made me laugh. Oh, darn. Oh, how's Kubla?
Well, his tendons bowed, but his spirit's really strong.
I couldn't hold him. Tried to take him off the rail. I tried.
The sprinkler spooked him, that's all. There's nothing you could have done.
I don't know, Simon. I'm afraid my best races are behind me.
Jimmy, life is a roller coaster. You know that. It's always got its lows and its highs.
And lows.
And highs. You can't have the highs without the lows. It's all part of the same ride.
How are Katie and Tim?
Oh. Look. They made you this.
Simon, no smoke now. Do you think Kubla will really be fit to race on Saturday?
Yeah.
I don't want any false hope, Simon.
Jimmy, there's no such thing as false hope. Until it's hopeless, all hope is real.
Come on, Kubla, you've got to eat.
Easy, honey. You can't force him.
Hey, how's everybody doing, huh?
Kubla's not eating. He's not even eating his favorites.
Where's Uncle Jimmy?
Well, he just had to stay in hospital a little bit longer. It's just doctor's orders. Hey, now, come on. Everything's gonna be all right.
No, it won't. Kubla is not gonna race Saturday. They're gonna take us away from Uncle Jimmy.
Why is everybody giving up? Kubla's not giving up, are you? No. Now, everybody under the age of 12, follow me. Come on.
Where are we going?
We are going to do something every kid dreams of doing, but they're not normally allowed to do it.
What? What's that?
Here you go, Kubla.
Here, Kubla.
Here, look. Oh. Go. Oh, bye. Come on.
Well, Alex.
I'm hungry.
Yeah, got you good that time.
Okay, now for you.
Simon Duck!
Wow, I'll get you.
Okay, now for you.
Oh, Tilly. Hey, kids, it's been a long day. We really need a hug, don't we?
No, you don't.
Yeah.
No, you don't. No. Oh,
well, more precisely, mud. With a hint of mint and a splash of sphagnum moss. I would offer you some more, Alex, but the rest is for Kubler. Mm, that should do. Now, easy, boy. This stuff should work miracles with that leg of yours. By morning, you'll be raring to run.
Is he going to be all right?
Well, no one here has given up on him.
Did you have an accident?
No.
Simon's mixing up an old Indian cure for Kubi's leg.
He really should see a good vet. I have an excellent specialist.
The Shoshone Indians depended on horses for their survival. They had specialists before specialists were invented.
I'm sorry Kubla's fire can't race in the futurity Saturday. I was really looking forward to seeing him up against the best.
Your trainer wasn't.
He doesn't like competition.
Yeah, I noticed.
Randy is very intense. But I put up with it because he's the best trainer in the country and very loyal to me.
Well, he better do a lot more training, because Kubla is not only going to run on Saturday, he's going to win.
Yeah!
Look, I know how much you all have riding on that race, and that's why I'm here. So that Jimmy won't have to risk losing his family on the outcome.
Well, how can you help?
Sell Kubla's fire to me. He's injured, but I'll pay a fair price. Enough money for Jimmy to satisfy the state adoption board.
Very generous.
A bowed tendon can be very serious. Some horses never come back from it. But in my stables, he'd have the best care money could buy.
But Kubla's Uncle Jimmy's dream. You can't sell somebody's dream.
That's right.
Want that horse.
Bismarck will run him into the ground on Saturday.
This has nothing to do with the race.
You want him for stud?
Oh, forget it. You wouldn't understand.
All right. I'm only your trainer. Well, maybe we should end that, too.
Oh, Randy. Now you know how much I need you. And maybe someday we'll get back what we once had. But right now, I need you as a friend and a trainer. Kubla's fire's just... He's the sort of horse I used to dream of as a girl. A stallion, a wild stallion with fire eyes. He's the horse I've always wanted.
On your own. You're here with people that love you.
I hate it when people die.
Well, they don't die, really. Not if you keep them alive in your heart and your thoughts.
But you can't talk to them, though.
Well, you can in your prayers, in your dreams. Especially your good dreams. They'll listen. Now, you lay down. Close your eyes. Good thoughts. Good dreams. Soon your mum and dad's love will surround you. Keep you safe. Very safe.
Simon.
Good night.
Simon, this gentleman is from the Department of Social Services.
Paul Holtzman, how do you do?
That depends.
I'm afraid I have a court order to place them in foster homes until they're hearing for permanent placement.
But there's no problem. They're happy here.
I'm sure they are, but that's irrelevant.
Happiness? Irrelevant?
Arrangements have already been made. Now, we've found them very lovely homes.
No!
You can't separate Tim and Katie. They need each other.
Everything has been done to find a single home for both children, but...
They've got a single home here.
Yes, but you're not a registered foster parent.
Well, sign me up.
Look, I'm sorry, but the children will have to come with me.
No!
We won't go.
Katie?
You lied. You said everything's gonna be all right, and it's not!
Katie, come, look.
I'll tell you what you can do with your court order, mister.
Now, Tilly, Mr. Holtzman's just doing what he's been hired to do.
I can't neglect my job.
Paul, tell me, how'd you find out that Katie and Tim were staying here?
Oh, I asked around the track and played a hunch.
And if you hadn't played your hunch tonight?
Well, I would have started looking again on Monday.
Well, so you wouldn't be neglecting your job if you came back then. You'd just be neglecting your hunch, right?
And we'd have them all ready on Monday morning, I promise.
Well,
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Oh, yes, but you know,
you have a great see you weekend. Monday.
We'll see you Monday. Let me show you the door.
Yeah, we'll see you bright and early.
I won't let them take you and Timmy away.
You say things like that, but it's not real. It's just make-believe, like everything here.
But everything here is real. I should know. I made most of it myself.
Real is when your parents die. Real is when Uncle Jimmy's in the hospital. And Kubla's not able to race.
Have you ever heard of a saying, turning poison into medicine? Do you know what that means?
No.
It means when you feel really small, and it seems like you can't change anything that happens to you, well, you just focus on what you can change.
What?
Well, how you feel inside. You see, if you keep a bright light burning inside you, then slowly it spreads, it really does. And pretty soon you'll be able to change anything that happens to you.
Yeah? Well, how do you even turn the light on in the first place?
That can be tricky. Sometimes you need a jump start. Come on, let me show you something. Come on. Start turning. Okay. Now get into the middle and jump.
But the rope will fall.
Maybe it will. Maybe it won't.
But it will.
Well, let go and find out.
How can it do that?
Anything's possible. Now let's see you jump. Great. Now, can you feel the light inside you?
Yes.
That's better. Now, I think you better get some sleep. You've got to get up early tomorrow morning to see Kubla. Doing out of hospital?
I couldn't lay there anymore. I snuck out. Where's Kubla?
Where's Kubla? He's in his stall.
He's not there.
Kubla!
Kubla!
How could you do something so blatantly idiotic?
Nobody saw me. I wore gloves. I timed it right. I put him in the trailer and was gone.
They're not stupid. They know I tried to buy the horse yesterday. Don't you think that's going to arouse their suspicions? Why? Why did you steal him?
You said you wanted him. I wanted him for you. So I went and got him. I can take him back if you want. I'll say there was a mix-up.
You're sure no one saw you?
Nobody. I can hide him.
No. Here's what I want you to do. Darken his coat and cover the white blaze on his forehead. Then alter his lip tattoo carefully. Put him with the other horses where he won't stand out.
Objectively, there's been no ransom note, so kidnapping for profit's out of the question.
Bleh. Couldn't make a profit off of me.
Well, who would profit from having Kubla?
I've told you, Whitney Ross.
Alex, the fact is, she does want Kubla, and keeping him out of the fortuity tomorrow can only increase her horse's chances of winning.
Believe me, Simon, I know which way the arrows are pointing.
Well, we could tell our suspicions to the police and let them investigate. Or we could pay a visit to the Ross stables and lay our suspicions to rest. Whichever you want.
Well, Alex, I thought while you were chewing the fat with Miss Ross, I might take a little look around.
Why do you always do this to me, Simon?
Do what?
Bring this bag.
It's gotten us out of trouble more than once.
Yeah, that's because when you've got it with you, you take too many chances.
Well, I just can't help myself. You know, it's like when I see a fogged mirror, I've just got to write something on it with my finger. When I see a chance, I take it. Like someone I know. Hey, you seen anyone new around?
They should have let me buy Kubla. I could have cared for him, protected him.
You have hundreds of horses, Whitney. Why did you want Kubla so badly?
Oh, I don't know. He touches something in me, something I can't
resist.
I stole Kubla?
It doesn't matter what I think.
Come on.
Where?
The stalls, the corral. I want you to look everywhere and satisfy yourself that Kubla isn't here.
Hey,
Kubler. Is that you? It is you. What have they done to you, Kubler? I'll be back for you. I promise. Okay, boy. Stay.
Well, you've seen everything. Kubler isn't here. Tell me, Alex, is it all women you don't trust? Or just me? Trust me, Alex. I have to get to the track. Will you drive me there?
I won't let him take Kubla away from me.
Randy!
Real Park. Today's feature, the eighth race, the Pacific Futurity for two-year-olds with a total purse money of $200,000. The paramutual windows are now open for wagering on the daily double, the select seven, and the first race. Post time for the first race is 12:30.
I don't even know why we're here. You're not going to find Kubla. If you were an Indian, they'd call you Black Cloud. But we're sunny skies, right?
Right. Mm. There's still time, Uncle Jimmy. And he's a wizard.
Up, get him inside. I had him where I wanted him. How could you lose control like that?
Because I'm tired of being treated like one of your horses you pad or whip to get what you want.
Randy!
Now, when we walked into that winner's circle today with Bismarck, I go in as your partner, and you feel like kissing somebody, you kiss me.
Get out! Get out of here before I...
What? Call the cops? Now, I might have stole the horse, but you decided to keep him and change his looks. So unless you want to trade all this in for jail, now on, you do what I tell you. Now move.
In there till I get back.
Make sure he doesn't get away. Understand?
Take care of him. Don't worry.
He ain't going anywhere.
What'd he do?
Well, maybe he didn't kiss good enough.
What's that?
you all right?
Yeah, I'm all right. What about you?
I'll live. What'd you do to the other two?
Oh, it's just some harmless sleeping gas. Look, it won't last long. We haven't got much time. You get the car, I'll get Kubler into the trailer.
Wait a minute, Simon. Simon, the keys. I lost them.
Oh, Alex.
If I lost them in this hay, we'll never find them.
Wait a minute. Let's try this.
Yeah, right.
There's no needles in there to distract me. Alex, it works.
All Pacific Futurity entry should be in the paddock.
Well, the stewards find out I didn't scratch Kubla by the deadline, they'll suspend my license. Doesn't much matter anyway.
It's Simon! Yeah! Did you find him? Is he all right?
You found him?
Got some explaining to do about how he looks, but he's raring to go.
Have you seen Whitney and Covington?
They were in the paddock.
I've got something to take care of.
I knew you would find him.
You really are a wizard.
I let you into a secret. We're all a wizard, we just don't know it. Now let's get Kubler ready for the race, shall we?
All Pacific Futurity entry should be in the paddock. This is the last call.
You! Call the police! I've got something for the loser circle here.
Attention, ladies and gentlemen. In the eighth race, number six, B's Reward will be wearing blinkers.
I've never been so nervous in my life. There's so much riding on this race. Simon, we're the long shot.
Jimmy, it doesn't matter where you start, it's where you finish that counts.
Your attention, please. The horses are coming onto the track for the 23rd running of the $200,000 Pacific Futurity, a 6-furlong race for 2-year-olds.
Bring right on up here. Bring right on in here. Right, come on, come on.
The horses are at the gate.
All right, Kubla. It's just you and me.
Doesn't Kubla look great?
Gosh, I can hardly recognize him.
Are you as nervous as I am, Timmy?
No.
Why'd you do it?
I don't know. Once I had him there, I couldn't let him go. It's that passion, that obsession we talked about.
I'm sorry.
Can't we wait until after the race?
It is now post time. The flag is up. And there they go. Great Way taking the lead on the inside. Wins Tokyo second. Bismarck, the Queen Horse is third. Approaching the far turn, Great Sway is still in the lead. Bismarck second, moving up on the outside. Queen Tokyo now third. And Peaceful Fatigue Reward Aware. And rounding out the field, Bare Knuckles and Kubla's Fire coming from far off the pace and beginning to make his move. as they round the grandstand turn and head for home. It's Bismarck in front, running strongly. Braithwaite holding on to second, wind stroking third and drifting wide. Then Kubla's fire moving up fast in the middle of the track. Bare knuckle, peace, movement, and be reward. Into the stretch, it's Bismarck in the lead. It's a two-horse race. Bismarck and Kubla's fire and Bismarck. Neck and neck, nose to nose. It's Kubla's fire taking the lead and driving hard. It's Kubla's fire pulling away. It's Kubla's fire in front. Bismarck second, Braithwaite with Stokey fighting the third. It's Kubla's fire out in front by two. It's Kubla's fire by three. Kubla's fire running easily. Bismarck in second, Braithwaite with Stokey still fighting the third. It's Kubla's fire all alone.
Well, it looks like the good guys won. Isn't there any way I can change your mind?
So am I. Come on.
66 to 1. Right in the bank.
Hey, Kubla. We don't want your horse of a different color for your victory photo, do we? Hey. Now you look more like a champion. Yeah.
Okay, let's have a smile now. Got it.
Stay tuned as a new look in designer jeans creates a fashion frenzy. Jack Warden and Ryan O'Neill star in So Fine, next.
Short skirts. Is the fashion industry hiking hemlines to hike profits? Aaron Moriarty with the story tomorrow on the CBS Morning News.